Beloved, you are a great one, of course, because God has made you a great one. God says that you were wonderfully and fearfully made. That is who you are. Our identity is very, very important. I welcome you back as a potential citizen, as well as a potential senator, because Senate sitting has taken place. And guess what? Last night around 3 a.m. as I deliberate with heaven, I got the passage, I got the permission to tell you, a potential citizen, a potential senator, to begin to decree according to the divine constitution. Because we are in dangerous moments, we are in emergency moment, and we need voices to be raised all over the world. Wherever you are a fan to the office of the prophet, I am charging you according to God's intention, according to heaven's permission, that as a potential senator, you have the authority to decree a divine constitution, which I'm going to give you today. Look at what it says in Psalm 2, verse 1. Why do the hinder rage and the people imagine a vain thing? The kings of the earth set themselves, the rulers take counsel together against the Lord, against his anointed, saying, let us break their bounds. Whoever they are, wherever they are on planet earth, be they government, institutions, organizations, whatever they are, who have taken evil counsel concerning COVID-19 vaccines, whatever, COVID-21 vaccines, whatever, the evil counsel they have taken, the Lord says, we shall lift a voice and decree, and it shall not stand. It shall not come to pass. It shall never come to pass. It shall never be established. Wherever you are, this is your mouth. This is your voice. You must lift every second. Even as you think around, begin to make that decree. Hold the ends of the earth and shake their agenda to the ground. The Bible says in Isaiah 7 also that the Ramaleah and Ephraim have taken evil counsel, and the Lord says it shall not stand. It shall not come to pass. Neither shall it be established. Beloved, this is the confidence we have. This is the hope we have, that insofar as there used not to be a Senate sitting, but God's grace, the office of the prophet, has established the first Senate sitting in the world, we stand on the basis and call you wherever you are to lift a voice to the Lord. And all you have to say continuously, the whole day, in the night, even when you are sleeping and you get up to urinate, all you have to continue to decree and it shall stand is that every evil counsel taken by whoever, the Hamans of our time, evil people, wicked people, governments, companies, whoever they are, that have taken evil counsel concerning COVID-19, COVID-21, vaccines, whatever. Look at this, a doctor in Florida took the vaccine and died after 16 days. What are you talking about? If those who know better in the medical field are taking the vaccine and they are dying, 87 nurses in Holland have refused and rejected the vaccine. That means something is involved. And you and I have nothing but to lift up a voice. And the voice is what I'm giving you. Just make a decree that every evil counsel taken, according to the Lord, that in the verse 4 of Psalm 2, it said, he that sitteth in heaven shall laugh. God shall laugh. Tell God to arise and laugh over the evil agenda. And the Bible says, and God shall set them in derision. In other words, God will set them in a failure. In other words, God will set them into a come to naught, because that is what we must do. There used not to be a Senate. There used not to be a true church. Forget of religious Christianity. They don't even understand what is going on. They don't even know the times in which we are. Mordecai said, who knows why God has brought the office of the prophet at such a time as this? Who knows why you have come into contact with the prophet over Netu at such a time as this? This is the reason I believe, because last night, 3 a.m., heaven gave me permission to tell my potential senators, potential citizens, to lift a voice and make a decree. Instead of the office of the prophet alone making the decree, today you have been granted permission So lift up your voice. Even you can hear me today and your desire has come and you have got a little understanding. All is your mind. Peter told his master, "Master, if it is you walking on the sea, let me also come." The master said, "Come along." The master never gave any excuse. He said, "Come along." All you need is your mind to have desire, to be interested in lifting a voice against evil men and women in the world who have teamed up with governments to kill people. It shall not stand. It shall not come to pass. Neither shall it be established. There are voices they have lifted. We are lifting a divine voice to cancel and nullify everything. So brother, sister, wherever you are, mother, father, wherever you are, just lift your voice. Let it be your song the whole day, the whole night. Wherever, even as you are walking, as you are doing exercise, as you are cooking in the kitchen, you go to workplace, wherever you are, let that be your voice. The Bible says they lifted a voice of war. We are lifting a voice of war against the wicked people, that their agenda shall not stand. The agenda shall not come to pass. The agenda shall never be established. It does not matter how far they have progressed. It does not matter how far they have progressed. Haman progressed and the wife said, "Hang Mordecai." And they were sitting and waiting. And to their surprise, Haman was the one who was brought to be hanged. God can hang them, even though they have set gallows to hang people. A whole doctor in Florida took the vaccine and died 16 days after. His brains exploded. Now, these are professionals in the medical field. Not to talk about many people who don't know. My brother, are we going to sit down? We have nobody to fight for us except the mountain of Zion, our God in heaven. So lift up your voice on the basis of the divine constitution in Psalm 2 and in Psalm 2 and Isaiah 7. Please spread this video because we need voices all over the world. Whether you understand or not, just build a desire and lift up a voice and say, the evil counsel of men, wherever on planet Earth, companies, government, whoever they are, it shall not stand, it shall not come to pass, neither shall it be established. That is all you need to do, my brother, my sister, because that is the hope we have. Thank God for the office of the prophet to come your way. Thank God for the office of the prophet to bring about the Senate sitting. That is what the world has never known. The true church, the Senate, the parliament of heaven. Insofar as you are a potential one, you have the all right, audacity, divine right, constitutional right to make a decree, to lift a voice. So let's lift the voice now, right now, wherever you are, and spread this to somebody else. Like it more so that it will explode. And subscribe if it is your first time, because we cannot afford to fool around. The people are progressing and we must stop them. They are an illegal system. Jesus judged them 2,000 years ago. It is we who lack knowledge. Our ignorance is our enemy. But today, you are no more ignorant because of the office of the prophet. You are no more ignorant because the office of the prophet has opened your eyes. The office of the prophet has given you enough knowledge and understanding. So all you are being asked now to do is to lift a voice and decree that every evil counsel pertaining COVID-19, COVID-21, and the vaccine will not stand, will not come to pass, neither shall it be established. God should scatter their bands. And God should set them in direction and make their agenda waste and useless. Nothing shall come out of it. May the Lord give you strength. May the Lord give you the anointing. May the Lord give you the wisdom, the understanding to lift up this voice for the sake of our fellow human beings all over the world. All human beings matter. God created them and God is in charge of them. And no one has the right to kill anybody. Whether that person contributes to the economy, whether that person is educated or not, nobody has the right. Look at these people, if not foolish people, the same people who said animals have right. Today, they think human beings don't have right to live? What the hell of nonsense is this? You must be angry. And in that anger, lift a voice. Lift an aggressive voice, an angry voice, because the Lord has given us permission. I was waiting And the Lord told me 3 a.m. that tell your potential senators that it is time to lift up a voice of war and make the decrees. And that is all I'm asking you. Lift up your voice in America, in Europe, in wherever, Arab world, in Russia, wherever you are, and you are part of this fold under the office of the office of the prophet. Lift a voice and say the wicked agenda on COVID-19 vaccine shall not stand, shall not come to pass, neither shall it be established. And the Lord will rise and make it come to pass. He that sat in heaven will laugh and say, their wickedness will come to naught. And that is what the Lord wants you to do. And that is what the Lord has sent me to tell you as the prophet of God's house. Be blessed. Remain committed. Continue till we have settled them. Don't stop. That is our assignment. God bless you.